Hello guys and welcome back to channel. In today's video we are going to look at this question over here. Like he want to say something about if a player buy or don't buy or sell anything in the shop, so shopkeeper should say something, and it can be done without using the plugin. It is very easy to make it. You just need two variables and you can just make a shopkeeper say something. Very easy. So I'm going to add the video link over here once we create it. So this is just today at 9:42, someone asked it and it's been like 3 hours. So these guys say you can use it by variables, but it will be like used to be on every single item. So this system that I'm trying to show you, which will be, doesn't matter which item it is buy or not, it doesn't really matter. It is not going to say the names of the item, but yes, if if player don't buy anything in the shop, shopkeeper say, oh please come back later if you make a mind. If it is sale, it will say, oh thank you for selling this and or buying this. Okay, so you need to make two variables. So first we are going to make a gold compare and gold holding. So gold compare means we are going to save the value of gold into this variable, and then we are going to save another same value of the gold in gold holding. It means, let's say if player buy anything, so gold is going to get decreased, that will be in holding, or if player sell anything, gold is going to increase and that will be in holding, and if player do not do anything, then these two will be the same. So first just create these two variables, okay, gold compare, and then we are going to go here in control variables and we are going to change gold variable equal to game data, and in game data we are going to change it to the gold. Okay, and similarly we are going to do it for the gold holding also. So before we open the shop, we are going to make sure that this shopkeeper will be having so which one we should be choosing here for look at that, she look good. Okay, so both of the variable will hold the value of gold before shop is opening. Now we are going to go and add the shop processing. Okay, here we are going to add some of the items. Okay, it doesn't matter you add the items or weapons or anything, it really not going to make any difference. Okay, so I'm going to add these items here, then we are going to add a couple of weapons, sword, and then okay, and then we are going to add some armors. Okay, okay, so as these things has been done, now we are going to change this seventh one. We are going to copy paste it again one more time. See, first we change it to the gold holding for holding the value, or it really doesn't matter if you don't have it, or you can just edit. Let's say if you hold these gold over here, and if you hold this, but make sure you add this seventh over here. If you don't add it, it might be keeping the same value. Let's say if you go for the second time in the shop, so this seventh variable or this gold holding variable will be having the value of last time, and that you don't want it. So that's why we are going to change both of these values same as the gold before we open the shop. Once we open the shop and once everything is done, we are going to change this holding value to the gold. Okay, and now we are going to compare the thing. So how we are going to compare? We are going to go into conditional branch. So now we are having three conditions: either our gold compare is equals to our gold holding. Okay, it means whatever is the gold value, it is similar to the then we are having either it is greater than or either it is less than. Okay, so we are going to change those stuff over here. Okay, these are the three conditions we are going to have. So let's say if we are having the gold same as the holding, it means a player do not buy anything. So we are going to say hello player, whatever it is name. So we can say, or you can just add the name of the, you know, like character please come back when you make mine. Okay, so this is what a shopkeeper is going to say. Let's say I'm just going to copy paste. Now gold compare is bigger. It means we are having the value gold holding is less. It means our character is having less value in the gold in his hand. So what it means? It means it have buy. So we can say thank you for buying at my shop. Okay. Sorry. Okay, and if my gold is less than the holding, so let's say we have sell anything, then we can say thank you for selling items at my shop. Okay, so these are the three things we are going to go and do. Okay, so this is the man who will give us the first 1000 gold. So I will just make sure you can just copy paste it. It is very easy. I will just hold this second for second. You can just pause the video and copy paste everything to your game. Here I'm just going to add the 1000 gold. Okay, and let me go and into the common events, not cost system. Let me delete those three of them, so they will not be at back of him. So if I play the game, okay, I will make a screen bigger. We are having the zero gold right now. We will go and buy some gold, I mean get some gold, and now we will go and buy something from shopkeeper. So let's buy at least two of these and antidote. Let's see. Okay, so if I press the escape button or even if I press anything like that, see, thank you for buying at my shop. So this is not working because I by mistakely put the wrong slash over here. So this is, so I just bought something from the shopkeeper, so it is saying me thank you for buying. So let's go and sell some of this stuff again. Okay, so I will sell the antique. I got the 260 gold, as you can see. Look at that. Thank you for selling items at my shop. Okay, and let's say I don't do anything now. So I check the, I don't like it, I go into sale, I don't want to sell it, I just cancel it. Look at that. Please come back when you make a mine. Okay, so this is very simple. All you need is just these two variables to make this thing, and shopkeeper will say whatever you want it. Okay, so I hope you like this video. Tell me if you want to make me any kind of tutorial. If you are stuck with something, I will definitely try to make those things without the plugins or plugins, if it is possible. So see you guys in the next video.